Good morning and welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by the Technical Director at Mila Resources, Neil Hutchison. How are you doing this morning, Neil?
Hey, good, thanks, Thomas.
Great. Good to have you on the line. And I think there have been some more results from Kathleen Valley. Can you talk us through them?
Yeah, sure. Look, yesterday we put out some news. It wasn't as favourable as what we'd all anticipated. We put in three new holes, four new holes this year, late this year. And whilst we had visually very, very strong shearing and sulfide and alteration within that zone, the assay results were a bit disappointing. If I put that, I'd just like to put that into context for the rest of the project. And that's that we've drilled now 38 holes into the project and 26 of those since Mila listed in November last year. And these are the first holes so far that have come back with less than economic grades. But that's quite expected within goldfields geology. Now, it's very typical for a gold system to form what we'll call chain of pearls, where you sort of get a nice big pearl and then you get a little narrow string and then you get you another pearl. And it's part of the general structural geology that we've got to work with. And we're still very confident based on the fact we've got so many good pathfinder elements, base metal elements still very anomalous within the shear systems. And we certainly believe we're still sort of working our way into the root zone. We've just got to find the next pod or the next load within the system.
All right. Now, how much of a setback do you think the results were, if at all?
Yeah, look, it's like anything, it's a little minor hiccup. We've been very successful so far. We haven't had any holdbacks or stoppages. And so this really is our first. Normally you get a lot of these stop starts early in your project. It doesn't change our plans for next year. We're still planning to extend a long strike into the shallower zones, which have been untested to date. We chose to do the deeper drilling this year to trace it down dip. This year we're going a long strike and we're completely open. We're still open to the south. So look, there's a lot more movement yet before we step back into the deep drilling, but it gives us plenty of time to analyse the data we've collected, look at the structural geology, look at our geochemistry and geophysics, and that'll help us be more predictable and predict where we think the next lens or load of the system is continuing at.
Great. Thank you, Neil. And if there's anything you'd like to add, just to say anything to our investment audience, then please fire away.
Yeah, sure. Look, be rest assured, we still have full faith in the project. We've got a good team. We're fully backed. We've got money in the bank. Like I said, our plans don't change for next year. We'll continue drilling on. And we aim to sort of get together based on the work we've done to date, get together a new JORC exploration target, which will help us guide us give some confidence that the project is still a very strong, robust, and potentially high-grade system located just next door to Bellevue Gold Mine, which is a very successful 3 million ounce deposit, which has multiple stacked loads. And that's what we're aiming for, is to find the other stacked loads within our system.
Well, very best of luck to you, Neil, and I hope you'll come back and give us an update before long.
Many thanks. Pleasure talking to you again.
And you. Take care.